The ultimate goal of Smart Trac Ultra is to make sure machines become more available and reliable so that operations can run without any unexpected breakdowns and downtime. In practical terms, this means sampling real-time machine data, such as vibration and temperature, and using it to anticipate machine failures and act on them before they impact production lines. The sensor uses many tools to make this happen. One of them is the bearings library, which houses over 70,000 types of bearing models for automatic calculation of parameters. With only your bearing serial number, you get all the fundamental frequencies automatically. This is especially useful because through these frequencies, you can accurately identify bearing faults and know exactly when it's to be inspected. We now have our bearing register on the platform, but where do we go from here? We can schedule samples to see these fundamental frequencies apply to a chart, for example. This is where you settle sample parameters to determine exactly how many rotations will be registered and data resolution for a specific analysis according to that operational context. Once data is sampled and it's back on the platform, we can start to play with these frequencies. For example, for a bearing wear, each of these peaks will represent the bearing rolling elements, hitting it and making sound. You can hear this sound by clicking the play button. The interval between peaks, and therefore between sounds, is the frequency we register in the beginning in the bearings library. This is one of the ways you can track machine condition, but the reality is that our sensor is constantly performing these analyses all the time, automatically. We were focused on increasing visibility into real-time machine condition, so we've developed the Machine Health Indicators tool. Before, you had to wait for an insight to be generated to know what was happening with your machine. Now, you can keep up with your machine conditions and health levels based on lubrication, alignment, fastening, temperature, and all the failure modes already detected in the insights. If you do get a failure inside on the platform, we get into what we call auto-diagnosis. Besides being warned about a potential failure based on real-time data sampled by our sensors, you get a specific diagnosis information based on benchmarking between similar assets and reverse engineering failures we've diagnosed in the past. If we get back to the bearing failure example we were discussing just before, you would get this specific identified fault, a behavior chart indicating failure severity, and prescriptive suggestions on what you can do to prevent this fault from escalating. There are many ways you can gain insight into the health of your assets within the traction platform. But at the end of the day, they all come together to make sure machines run smoothly and reliability teams can get their work done.